Yo, what is going on, guys? This is Captive, and for today's video, I am going to be showing you guys how to get better FPS on Minecraft on your laptop or PC, whatever you guys are using. For this video, I am actually using a MacBook Pro. That doesn't really matter. It will work for all computers. I am actually using an Elgato so that we see the actual FPS gain by doing the steps that I'm going to take you guys through. So let's just hop right into a world and show you what I'm getting for FPS. I want to say the first time I've loaded up this world, it did take quite a while because my computer isn't very good. It's not really meant. See how it's blue? It actually did pretty good right there. It got it up nice and quick. So if we go and hit F3 or FN, F3 if you are on Mac, you can see that I'm getting about 35 FPS standing still. Once I start moving around, I'm going to be dropping down into the low and high 20s. It would be playable. It's not really the best. This is actually better than it was doing earlier when I tried to record. So this is actually kind of okay. I would say this is playable. When you look down at the ground, you get 60 FPS actually. But once you start looking up, you start struggling. So let's go right on into options and then settings, video settings. So when you look at this, if you just want to play the game, you're not playing multiplayer or anything like that, you can really just turn this to fast graphics. Stuff won't look as nice. And we're going to turn clouds all the way off. So by doing that, you're going to go up into like the mid-40s, high 30s. mid-30s, stuff like that. This is a little bit better, a little more playable. You don't get as much skip and things like that, which is pretty nice. But if you're playing like Bed Wars and stuff like that on servers, you're going to want to do these couple steps. You're going to turn your max frame rate down to 60 FPS just so that it can try to cap it at 60 FPS and try to lock in on that 60 FPS. Next, you're going to want to turn your particles down to decreased. VSync isn't really important. Entity shadows, not really important. Other than that, you can also do some other things like chunk distance. Just go down a couple. Make sure if you're playing on a bigger Bed Wars map, like I've been saying, that you still load in the whole map because that could be a disadvantage. I don't want that happening. Full screen really doesn't make that big of a difference from my knowledge. But now if we go back into the game, as you guys can tell, this is a lot better. We're in the 40s almost the entire time. It's jumping up into the mid-50s too, which is actually really playable. So if you guys did enjoy today's video, make sure you guys leave a like. It would mean a lot to me. One of my recent tutorial videos actually just went from like 15,000 views all the way up to 28,000 views, and it's jumped up a bunch of likes and a bunch of new people are here. So I just wanted to put out a video to make sure you guys were still all active on the channel. I will be doing more tutorial videos hopefully now that I'm getting a little more time. Midterms are done, so make sure you guys check it out once I start releasing more content. If you guys are new, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Like I said, turn notifications on. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been Captive. I will see you guys in another video sometime soon. Peace out.